Hi, my name is Martha, and I work here at NASA in the Launch Services Program. I'm excited to have you here today to explore one of the many fascinating jobs here at NASA. To experience what it's like to be a NASA employee, you first have to speak our language. I've been told we speak a lot of acronyms in our conversations. With that being said, I'm going to let you be the judge.
Hey, Rex.
Hey, Smitty.
Is the LSIM scheduled at OCO 2 door the ONC building?
Yes, the PHSF HVAC INT is A-OK, and the OD Wilco's are due PDQ. And I'll let you know ASAP as soon as I hear the rest of it.
The acronym we're going to learn today is LSP. Can anybody tell me what LSP stands for? I'll give you a hint. I mentioned it earlier in our conversation, and it's where I work. You got it. Launch Services Program. Congratulations, you are now part of the NASA team. And now that you're part of the NASA family, I have someone I'd like for you to meet.
Hello, my name is Jermaine Oliver, and I also work in the NASA Launch Services Program in Flight Analysis as an aerospace engineer. Before I started working at NASA, I went to college at Tuskegee University, earning degrees in both aerospace engineering and physics. At NASA, my job is mission design. Other engineers and I work together to ensure the spacecraft is placed in the correct orbit. Right now, I'm working on the Orbiting Carbon Observatory, or OCO2. On July 1st, this mission launched aboard a Delta II rocket to study the carbon dioxide, or CO2, in the Earth's atmosphere. NASA chose to launch OCO2 from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California because this location is the best for launching into a polar orbit. It also provides a shorter distance for the spacecraft to travel, minimizing the fuel needed and saving money for the people of America. In order for OCO2 to get into space, my job in mission design is to provide the trajectory, that is, the path of flight, to safely place the spacecraft in a low Earth polar orbit and calculate the exact timing to insert it into the Earth Observing Satellite Afternoon Train, or the A-Train. The A-Train is a group of NASA satellites that follow each other along an imaginary track in space, just like a train does on Earth. The A-Train circles our planet every 98 minutes, crossing the equator at 1:30 p.m. solar time every day. The first satellite in the A-Train is GCOM W1. My job is to calculate inserting OCO2 in front of GCOM W1. OCO2 will be looking for the largest concentrations of CO2 on Earth. By combining the data from these satellites, scientists will be able to gain a better understanding of the important boundaries related to climate change. Riding the A-Train is like taking a scenic train ride across the countryside of the atmosphere.
I hope that meeting Jermaine today has inspired you to excel in your studies so one day you will find your dream career.